Hello, welcome to Art Snacks. Today we're going to draw a bighorn buck. And so we're going to start with some basic shapes. We're going to start with an oval. It's going to be the head. We're going to kind of cross that oval with a shape that kind of goes like this. Okay. And from there we're going to kind of go on back. A shape like that. That's the beginning. Now we're going to come on down. And make a couple of these. And then the back, we're going to kind of make a shape that does this and this. And then behind that, kind of double up, make another one like that. And then up on the head, we're going to kind of just start to create a shape that looks like this. They don't have to match exactly. There's two on both sides. Okay, so now we have the sort of fundamentals of the animal. Okay. All right, so now let's jump in and sort of do some more sort of identifying of areas. So this is the back of the neck that goes into sort of a muscular hunch here and then sort of drops down like that. Now this is going to go on into this back hunch in this area here. Okay, and beside that, basically we mirror that again. This one's a little higher up. Okay. Okay. Now let's go across with the stomach. Now the leg. A little wider and more muscular up here. This would be the equivalent of a forearm for a person. Then we get sort of a kneecap and then coming down to foot that looks kind of like that. The other, we're going to come out with the front here. It's a muscular looking area. And then up to the neck and bring in another foot. The fun thing about these feet is once you've done one, you pretty much got it figured out. So you can do another one. Okay. Now on the very back, there's just a little bit of an indication of a tail back here. We haven't done any hair yet, but we'll deal with that in just a little bit. Okay. Now up here on the head, let's get busy on that and take a look at what that looks like. The basic shape is going to kind of do this and this. I'm going to kind of come in like this. It's the basic head shape, okay? Now with the horns, it gets interesting because we're really making a fairly interesting shape. We're coming around and up, okay? But up here, this thing happens where the horn sort of twists. Before we draw any more, we'll put the ear in there. Then bring this around. Okay, this one, similar, we'll do the outside first. Other ear. Bring this around. Now what makes that look more realistic is little texture lines that this has. Sort of follow the contours of the horns. Okay, now eyes way out here to the outsides. One here, sort of one here. Okay, now we're going to come down the nose. Let's do that nose. The muzzle. Okay, now some indications of the way the hair grows here. I can always make those ears just a little bit bigger by making them dark. Now, the end of the muzzle is not as dark. coming down the neck. Let's come on down the neck here with some hair. Let's put this right in here. Following the contour of the body. Remember, things are darker underneath, right? Now we're going to go in here, and there's some musculature here, and that's the muscles underneath the hair that we have to represent. Okay? Start working our way back this way. Some texture. All the shading is expressed in lines that can double each one as hairs. Okay. Working our way back in these sort of layers. If this was a finished drawing, that would take a lot more time. If this is a sketch, this is a learning opportunity. Chance for me to learn sort of how this animal is made. Now please understand, I will do 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 studies of this before I think that I'm anywhere near good enough to do a drawing I would hang on the wall. Okay? Now I'm going to work my way down this way. And now coming down this way. The back leg is darker, okay? This is sort of the basics of the animal. And the rear end's a little bit bare back there, okay? Now let's put him on a rocky sort of outcropping. So he's in his natural habitat, in his environment. This bighorn buck. This is a young bighorn buck, younger than youngish. Few indication marks like this make this seem more rocky. And you could put a mountain landscape in the background and make him really stand out. You could have some peaks back here. You could use the side of your pencil to create some contrast with the buck and with his little craggy outcrop. And on the other side, maybe a few clouds to indicate that he's up high. A lot of people will draw clouds and make them sort of white, and the outlines will be too pronounced. And see, clouds don't have dark outlines, so I just like to sort of indicate clouds with sort of some strokes when I'm using pencil, but you can do it any way that you want to. Okay? There is our bighorn buck. See you next time.